Hey, I'm Lori from Here by Lori, and I'm here with Grace today. Say hi.
Hi.
Today we are going to show you a fun Christmas tree style for short hair. You could do it on longer hair still, but I know, especially for those of you out there with short hair or you've cut your little one's hair, it can be tough thinking about the holidays, and you might be missing out on fun hairstyles because all the tutorials are for longer hair. So we wanted to make sure that your little one with short hair has a fun hairstyle to do. So I'm going to show you a beautiful Christmas tree braid. You could switch it up and do red ribbon and make it like a Santa's hat style, which is particularly cute, I think, on little ones like Gracie. I love it. It's darling. So let's get started on how to do this Christmas tree style. Okay, so I've started by just wetting her hair out and brushing it. On her baby fine hair, I find it's just a little easier to work and get it to stay in nicely if I wet it a little bit. So I'm going to take, I've done a side part over here. I'm going to take my comb and part across her head towards the front. Let's see here.
I want the sound out the way.
The hair's in your way. That's okay. To make sure I've got neat part lines, sometimes it takes a couple tries, and I'll just run my comb along where I want that part line to be. And then as you pull your comb up, you can just kind of see which hairs are supposed to be on which side of it. And pull it that way so that you're separating the hair and creating that part line that you want. So once you've got your part line just angled forward ever so slightly there, secure the rest of the hair out of the way and pick up a section of hair here at the beginning. We're going to do a Dutch lace braid. Dutch means it's going under versus going over in a French, and lace means we add hair on one side. So take this outer one, go under the middle, this outer one, under the middle. And now we're going to begin adding hair in. And come along here, pick up a section of hair going back, add it in, go under. This side just comes under. And then keep adding in hair as we go along. Take it, go under. This side just comes under without adding hair. Okay, go under, under. Add hair. Under. And you'll see then your braid is going to fall, so it just sits along the part line. So I'm going to come around over here and I'm going to braid out a few more stitches. These braids are just so adorable. Okay, I'm going to let down the rest of the hair here, and then you're going to come along. So this is where our top of our Christmas tree is going to start, or if you want to do the Santa hat option, you could do that too. But it's that same shape. So our triangle, it's going to be right about here where we first start that braid. So I'm going to take my comb here and part out at an angle from that. And then this hair here that I don't want to fall back over, I'm just going to take and twist that and clip it out of the way. Now this hair, so you see I've got like a triangle here. I am going to take and braid this starting at the top, and we are going to repeat that process of the Dutch lace braid over here, and it's just this section of hair that we're going to braid. So start my three strand braid. This side's just going to go under, this side under. Now I'm going to begin adding in hair on this side only, and I'm going to pull my braid so that it goes along this part line. Okay, so I've kind of used off the hair that I've sectioned off, and this ends about in a line with where this one ends with taking the hair in. So I'm just going to braid out a few more stitches here. Okay, so now you can see you've got like the sides of it. So this could be the sides of our Christmas tree braid. That's what we're gonna do today. But I wanted to share with you about doing a Santa hat with it. You can just use red ribbon, and then you take like a cotton ball or a little white, you know, like one of those craft puffs. You can glue it onto a bobby pin or something and stick that at the top, put a white bow at the bottom, and then you've got a Santa hat. It's just adorable, especially on the little ones. I think it's extra cute. Today we're going to show you the Christmas tree braid, though. So we've got our two braids. So I'm going to take my ribbon. I'm going to use the 3 feet one that came in my Christmas tree braid kits that are available on Amazon. And I am going to come along, and rather than going from here up to here, I want it to go across. So on this side, I'm going to come down a couple of stitches, and that's where I'm going to start to weave it in. So I'm going to come along right about here. Pick this up and then lace it through, and then on this side come to that very first stitch, pick it up, and you just want to make sure you're really gentle with picking it up. Most little ones like Gracie here have pretty fine hair. If you pull too much, it's going to slip out of the braid. Just pull a little and you will be fine, just kind of like tucking that ribbon down in there. And now we're going to lace this up like you're lacing a shoe. First, make sure you've got an even amount of ribbon on both sides. Okay, and now we're just going to go back and forth with pulling up a little of the hair and tucking it through. And because her stitches are so close together in her braid here, you don't even have to go every stitch. You could go every other one if you wanted. Here I've skipped one. Or if you want a really tight braid and you want to see a lot of the ribbon, you can go every stitch. So whatever you prefer there. And I like the look of going down and under through it versus coming up and going under that way. So, or going down and over, I guess that would be. Okay, so we're just going to continue going all the way out like this. Okay, so I've come down to this part. Because it's so little, I'm not going to pull these two sections together like I do in my other Christmas tree braid, if you've watched that tutorial. But on her short hair, I'm going to leave it a little bit wider. I'm going to take the ends of my ribbon here and just cross them like that and tie them in a bow. Okay, now I'm going to come along with some decorations. You could decorate it however you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and put a gold star at the top. And because I'm using one of my kits that I'm selling, I'm going to use just the decorations from that to make it nice and easy. So I'm going to add her gold star there. In my kits, I do have a garland option, an ornament option, and then an LED light option. And you could use any of them in the style if you wanted. I'm going to do the ornaments. It's the simplest to put in. So if you are using one of my kits, they come with 9 of these. Okay, and then the last thing I wanted to mention is if you want to make it, kind of further exaggerate the look, you can come along and gently pull on the edges of the braid to pancake it. I can't do it too much because Gracie's hair is pretty short, and because her hair is fine. If I do it too much and we let her run off and play, it's gonna help it fall out. But I think it kind of like gives you the fluffy, look of a Christmas tree then a little bit more. Thanks so much for watching today's tutorial. I hope if you try it at home that it turns out great for you. If you try it and want to share a photo, I would love to see. You can post on my Facebook page or tag me in a photo on Instagram at Hair by Lori. And if you like today's video and style, please give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials. Tell them subscribe.
Subscribe to our channel.
Subscribe to our channel and be sure to come back because we are doing a 12 Braids of Christmas series. So check out all of the Braids of Christmas. Thanks guys, have a great day.